Now let's talk about heat-related emergencies. We obviously have a gentleman here who's been working at the press. It's a hot environment, and we can tell that because he's sweating so profusely. He also began to feel dizzy and needed to sit down. Now, though he had a bottle of water nearby, he's probably not keeping up with the sheer amount of water loss that he's been experiencing. So what are some of the signs and symptoms of heat exhaustion? Obviously, profuse sweating, dizziness, extreme thirst, and cramping. Cramps in the abdomen, cramps in the legs, these are all signs that his electrolyte balance is getting out of whack and that he's losing too many fluids. If this isn't stopped, if we don't intervene at this point, it's going to progress to the next level, which is heat stroke. And that is probably different in that they're going to go from wet to dry in most cases. They stop sweating because they don't have enough fluids to lose, and they go unresponsive, unconscious. If this person goes unresponsive and is not breathing normally, we're going to start CPR. Remember, when they start to lose consciousness, or if they're not breathing normally, that's a 911 call. We're going to activate EMS by calling 911, and we're going to try cooling them down. If they can't drink anything safely, we're going to need to find water from a hose, from a bucket of water, cups of water, and start really pouring the water down over their body, on their clothing, to bring their core temperature down as best we can. If we're able to put cold packs underneath their armpits or around their neck, that's another great way to try to cool them down. Remember, recognizing that a person is coming into heat-related emergencies and getting to them and reversing that before they hit heat stroke is the best way of survival from this type of emergency.